I'm Vincent Gemont. I'm responsible of project and system administration in RTL. And RTL is the main French-speaking TV station in Belgium. We decided to do Virtual Studio 10 years ago when we moved in this building with a new facility. And we want to simplify the way we do regular show, because previously every time we want to do a show, we had to take 2 days just to build the set. When we came here, we decided to do it virtual because we can change the studio in 5 minutes. We can change everything, so it was a lot easier to shoot more shows on the same day without complication. You came just in time with the Unreal solution, and then we switched directly to the Unreal design. We chose zero density and dream roll because we know that dream roll they have a big crew and they know how to design set and everything, and they are in Belgium. They are really close from here. Some people from dream roll came to RTL to help us to start the project, and then now we do everything, almost everything, by our own, and it's quite easy.
I'm Christophe Piret. I work for RTL for 19 years now. Yeah, I'm a graphic designer and now tech artist. I used to work on the virtual sets since we begin with virtual sets 10, 11 years ago. We have 4 reality engines for the tracking system, 4 cameras with the type system for the tracking. We have 2 local engines for the conception of the graphic department. Normal show, we have 1 operator which is live, and we in the graphic department we have a team of 3 persons who are building the scenes and the setups.
Hi, I'm Yuri. I'm a TV operator at RTL. It's been 12 years I'm doing this job. And it's been now a year since I use zero density. The big advantage of the zero density is that you can have all this interface very, very graphical for just the user that I am in my case. It's pretty easy to work. A lot of people are on the same software, but in different version.
The texture, building, everything was pre-calculated for real-time setting, and with Unreal Engine and zero density, we do everything mainly except for the modeling and the construction of the scene. Lightning, texturing, everything is done with the Unreal Engine and zero density. The football show, the Champions League, the local football show is in virtual.
The Sunday show, politics Sunday show, is in augmented reality and virtual reality for the background, and that's the same for the elections.
On the election, we were in augmented reality with a lot of virtual element in the studio, and it looked better than a real studio. So people were surprised, and they told us, oh, okay, it's a beautiful design, so yes, they like it.
We have a representation of the election, and the journalist is triggering and controlling all the ZD application with a tablet. We have made a dedicated software to be able to choose what result we want to display, and she is able to start the animation and to display the information directly live on.
For the election, we had to play some data-driven graphics. So we had a programming team that they send us a JSON file, with a JSON parser, we were able to get the data and assign it to our graphics and play it correctly with the correct data to play all the graphics, the maps, the bar graphics, the line graphics, the pie charts, everything with the JSON parser. We get the data and we use it as a simple text file.
It's all, I will say, the quality of the render engine and of what you see on screen. It looks really better than before. That's the main advantage. The other advantage we have with the zero density is the internal chroma key, where you can have the chroma key in the composite of the scene, and then you have real way to handle shadows and everything on the screen. It looks really, really real with this technology. Every time we ask a question to zero density, we get an answer very quickly, so that we are really happy with the support and everything. Yes. In general, the people are really professional, so we like them. And IBC, I think 3 years ago, and we discovered the new way of doing Virtual Studio with the Unreal Engine, and this was a revolution for us.